previous video we had a look at the Woodland Scenics shaper sheet and the shaper sheet plaster for creating hills and terrain and stuff. As you can see here, this is the section above the tunnel at the other end of the canal on what will eventually be the winter scene. The plaster is now fully set and we've carved sort of rock strata lines and stuff on the bits that I need. So in this video we're now going to have a look at painting this. So the kit we're using is this one by Woodland Scenics. It's the Earth Colours kit and the part number is C1215 and contains a plastic mixing palette, a foam brush and 8 colours, and the colours are, as you can see there on the right, is yellow ochre, burnt umber, raw umber, black, slate grey, stone grey, concrete and white. So inside the box you get your plastic mixing palette tray, your foam brush, your colours, you get a instruction sheet in 4 different languages with English instructions printed on the back of the box. The technique we're going to be using to first of all do our rock face is a technique called leopard spotting, which has been shown many times on Woodland Scenics YouTube channel, but we're going to have a look at it today. So to start, we first of all have to add what they say is a secondary colour wash, and they give you various suggestions on the instructions here. So the two colours I'm going to use is burnt umber and stone grey. Once we've done them, it says to then add a dominant colour wash, and we're going to use one of these 3 colours here, either black, slate grey, raw umber. We'll see how we get on. It says for doing the wash, basically use 1 part liquid to equivalent to 16 parts water. But you can alter the ratio to suit your needs. So, with your plaster, as I said before, is already dry, and we've mixed up a wash with the burnt umber. We're now going to basically apply this onto the plaster. If you want to make it a bit more darker, just keep going over the bits you want to apply to. Like so. So now we add our second colour, and we're going to go for stone grey here and add this on some of the bits that I've purposely not gone for, and mix it in on some of the bits we've already done. So again, as per the instructions, it's 1 part of the pigment to about 16 parts water. Now, having got my first 2 washes layers on here, I've gone and put some more burnt umber on, but I've done this neat to highlight some areas like here, there and there. The next thing we're going to do now is what they call as the dominant wash. So they again is 1 part liquid and 16 parts water, And this is the black wash. Now apparently, according to the instructions here, this is supposed to tie sort of everything in together. So we'll crack on and do this now. The same with this is just to basically, with the black one, is to go over the whole lot, and apparently it's supposed to tie everything in together. Right, I'll come back to you in a few minutes. So we've now added the final dominant wash layer on here, and it's now a case of having to let it fully dry. The next stage after this is to take some Woodland Scenics Scenic cement, spray this on here to seal it, let it dry, and then add one final coat of this black pigment layer, watered down to one part pigment to 32 parts water this time instead of 16, and then let that dry. So while I'm waiting for this dominant layer to dry, we'll now have a look at doing the top part here. And we're going to use, again, it's by Woodland Scenics, and it's the earth colours, liquid pigment, earth undercoat paint, and it's the catalogue number C1229. Have a shop around on the internet for the best prices on this. So it's just a case of either brushing this on with a brush or with the foam brush off the kit. It may need a second coat of this, depends how it dries. We've now completed the painting on the top layer here. As I thought, it needed a second coat, so I've had two coats of the Woodland Scenics earth coloured liquid pigment paint. So just to recap again, the catalogue number is C1229, and it's the earth undercoat. We're now going to let this completely dry, and then what we'll be doing is to spray some Woodland Scenics Scenic cement. You can actually brush this on as well if you wish, and the catalogue number for this is S191. This already contains a wetting agent in it. It looks like the consistency of milk, and it's great for applying your scenic scatters. So what we'll be doing next on here is adding the earth scatters. So we'll be using Woodland Scenics fine earth turf to get the base layer of the turf down, and then we'll look at adding the static grasses. The other thing we'll have to do, as we've already mentioned, is to put the final weathering black wash pigment on here, but we'll allow this to dry overnight now before doing that. So now we're a couple of days later, and what we've done is that we've added a coating of the Woodland Scenics Scenic cement spray to seal all the rock face and this stuff. Once that's dried, we've gone over with a dark wash of the Woodland Scenics earth terrain paint, but we've used a solution of one part pigment to 16 parts water, so it's a slightly thicker mixture, and we've gone over all the whole rock face with that. Once that's dried, we've gone over with another coat of the Woodland Scenics Scenic cement spray to seal it all in. We've also added some foliage. We've used the Woodland Scenics dead foliage to try and create as though it's foliage back end of autumn, winter. So we've added around here, up the sides, and then we've used some green foliage stuck under there, and we've darkened it off with some dark coloured washes to try and represent sort of foliage towards the end of the year. We've also added some foliage, again, Woodland Scenics dead foliage down here. We've got to add some of the Woodland Scenics earth scatters on here, and then be adding the static grasses. Now, we had a bit of an accident on this bit here, which was some of the dark wash had run out onto here. But what I've decided with that is that because this is all going to be covered in snow and ice, we're going to use some of the deluxe materials Aquamagic, and we're going to put a thin coating of that on here to represent like an ice, frozen puddle. So with the darker colour showing through underneath, and with a sort of covering snow around here. So my idea behind that is that any sort of water that's sort of been running down the rocks has seeped off the rocks and then run across the lock side here, and with it being a cold spell and snowing and whatever, it's frozen on here. So this is just to give you a rough idea of what we're going to be sort of doing next, which is to be adding a retaining wall along here, and we will be adding sort of part of like wall in capping stones going across, joining onto the rock face, so it's like building the retaining wall out. And so with the capping stones sort of running off down here, and with the edging around there. Now, as the canal is running off stage, we're only going to represent part of the tunnel that the canal is sort of going off for the hillside. So at this corner here, this is only just roughly stuck in place, just to give you guys an idea. It's part of the tunnel entrance, you can see part of the arch there, and the front part of the tunnel, and part of a side retaining buttress there. So moving to the area above the tunnel here, we've added a coating of the Woodland Scenics Scenic Cement spray and covered the whole area here, and we've added Woodland Scenics fine earth turf coating all around the whole top board here, and we've added Woodland Scenics, it's the equivalent to like the N-gauge fine red sort of ballast granite chippings for the driveway. We've added some earth turf there, the middle represents the middle of the track, with a darker wash to represent sort of the darker muddy areas between the edge of the track and the grasses into what will be the wooded sort of area here, and the bushes and grasses area around here. We'll be adding a fence of some kind across the front here and along the edge there. We'll be using winter grade coloured static grasses on here, and we've got some snow covered like fir trees, which will be, as I say, we'll be adding along the back and down the sides here. So once that's all done, we'll be adding some deluxe materials Scenic Snow, and this is the Scenic Snow starter kit, I would say. And in here it comes with the Scenic Snowflakes, the big bottle on the right side there, the wee bottle, small bottle there, that has like ice sparkles, and you have like a funnel you can just see at the back there which attaches to that for finally applicating that to the layout. And then to seal it all, you've got Scenic Bond glue, which is basically like the equivalent of Woodland Scenics Scenic Cement spray. Deluxe Materials also do a deep shoveled snow scatter material as well, which will be getting hold of that and adding some of that onto some areas, like either side the track here, so the track's been cleared into like the footpath, and other areas on this section of layout. So we're slowly getting there with this. So in the next video we'll have a look at doing like with the static grasses and with some of the bushes and stuff. Thanks for watching.